Annie Leibovitz, let's talk about her first. Her compound is up to sale.
Yeah, photographer Annie Leibovitz has put her compound on the market for $33 million.
Covered in
it
ivy.
Is absolutely amazing.
What a place.
This is actually three separate townhomes that she bought and combined together. She gutted everything. They're beautiful living spaces, offices, wide plank wood floors. Mm. The property includes 13 fireplaces. So if you ever get cold in this mansion that's over 10,000 square feet, you have plenty to keep
you warm.
So make
sure you don't go to bed with about 10 of them
going.
It sounds dangerous.
Right.
And going for just a little $33 million, which is nothing. Rachel Bilson, who I confess I did not know who she was, but of course that's because she's a teen actor
yes,
of some sort.
Yes, she's a teen actress. She's best well-known for being on the OC. This is her house here. Mm-hmm. She just sold it for $2.2 million. It was a quiet sale. It actually sold to an entertainment executive before it actually hit the market. And it's absolutely adorable. It's a Spanish villa from the 1920s, has stained glass windows, a beautiful courtyard, fountain with a mosaic tile outside. And the interesting thing is, you would say, why does she want to give this up? It's beautiful. Mm-hmm. Well, we've heard that she and her boyfriend Hayden Christensen are looking for a home together, and he also has put his Studio City, California home up for sale. If you want that one, it is $2.5 million and around 6,000 square feet.
2.2, yes, yes.
Yep, so moving on, moving in.
Not bad. Yeah. So that's a better deal. Bel Air, we have one that's going there.
This one is stunning. This one's absolutely gorgeous. This is the home of the former owners of Architectural Digest. Yeah, so it is designed by renowned architect.
Look at that.
Hugh Newell Jacobson, and is on the market for $20 million. It got a price cut. It was 17% brought down from $24 million. As you see, it has these gorgeous pyramid slate roofs and has three bedrooms, 10 bathrooms, gorgeous gallery space. This is not a home for a child. I mean, the sculpture garden, the motor court, these absolutely gorgeous hallways.
Serious breakage.
Yes, you do not want a five-year-old playing in this area.
Okay, and Burl Ives' former home, just in Montecito, California.
Yep, this last one is in Montecito.
$18.8 million.
It is on the market for $18.8 million. It actually was also owned by Amy DuPont, who was the youngest daughter of Eugene DuPont way back in the day. It was built in 1917 and has six bedrooms, seven bathrooms, a wraparound terrace. It's got some beautiful copper wainscoting and an Italian marble fireplace. And its current owners are going back to Texas, so you can have it all.
All there for the taking.